Well, welcome on inside the Honda Center, getting ready to drop the puck. Of course, Kings and Ducks. You heard from Stoll, you heard from Solani. They're ready to get it going. A big matchup, Staples matchup in goal. Jonathan Quick still continues to play. He's been solid, he's been good. The Kings know, Bob, as we just touched on the open, it's about the offense, finding enough goals. Jonas Hiller did not play last night. The Ducks in a back-to-back. He is their number one guy. Struggled this year a little bit with bad goals. We'll see what he has tonight. Right now, play-by-play. Bob Miller.
All right, Jim, thank you very much. We are underway here in the first period. Kings have it. Here's Penner on the left wing. Duck zone. He shoots, and it's wide to the left. Rebound taken by Sheldon Surrey. Surrey, a newcomer to the Ducks this season, sends it to the King line. Taken there by Doughty. He got it back out to center ice. The Kings have won three straight in five of the last six meetings with the Anaheim Ducks. Anaheim 4-1-1 in their last six. They're off to their best start since 06-07, and that's the year they won the cup.
Yeah, they wanted to get a quick start. They have a quick start. What to watch for tonight? Centers of attention. It's a great matchup down the middle. Both teams strong at the center position. Just touched on in the open. LA traffic. Get the bodies to the front. The Kings have been talking about. They're on the perimeter. Get to the front. Of course, down low. It's a big battle down low in the Kings zone. The Kings don't have the size they used to, so it's about body position. It's about stick position. It's about denying the back of the net against the Ducks. If their big forwards get it, they can be so effective on the cycle holding it down low.
So the Kings now with Kopitar out at center for the Ducks. They've got Getzlaf with Valesky and Perry up front, and a faceoff won by the Kings. One by Kopitar. Here's Justin Williams on the right wing. Dustin Brown over on the left side. In deep, check thrown there by Kopitar. Puck comes up in the air and bounces down to the blue line and out to center ice. Dustin Brown back to get it. Now driven across the line, tipped in by Justin Williams. Williams goes back behind the net. Williams tries to take it there, but the Ducks can't clear. Held in by Martinez, then he ran into Corey Perry to keep Perry from getting to a loose puck.
It looks right now the Ducks want to match the top line against the top line. I just mentioned the centers of attention. That last shift, Kopitar against Getzlaf.
Back up to center ice. Poke checked away there, back to the King blue line. You know what's great, Jim? This you talk about this rivalry and this building lively already with teams from cheering for both teams. Fans from both teams cheering here tonight as the puck comes around the boards and Ducks have it in their own zone. Can't clear it out. Held into the right point. Driven down along the left wing side. Chased down there and held in by Simon Gagné up the middle and a shot hit the side of the net. Kings with it again. Here's Jarrett Stoll. Stoll got knocked down. That shot was by Lewis. Here's Gagné with a shot. It ricochets in front to Lewis and his shot wide to the left. Picked up by Bobby Ryan.
What a bonus it would be, Bob, for this line to get on the board.
And they take it away and a shot up high and over the net, knocked away. The shot by Gagné. Now chased down by Lewis. Lewis down the corner. He gets checked by Bobby Ryan. Lewis still going for it. Taken away by Palmieri. Had a big game last night on his birthday, his 22nd birthday. Had two goals. He throws it deep in the King zone and back to get it now. The Kings start out again. Jake Muzzin, rookie defenseman. Now up ahead to center ice, Colin, but the Kings go offside as Fraser flipped it across the blue line. Offside, Kings.
With all the talk about the rivalries, Bob, Daryl Sutter this morning at the morning skate talking about, you know, Jarrett Stoll just touched on it, where, you know, both teams, a lot of players from both teams skated together in the offseason and got together to work out because of the lockout and those types of things. And Daryl said, game sure has changed. Back in his day, you wouldn't even talk to a player on the other team in the offseason. Of course, you might nuzzle up every once in a while after a game for a beer or so, but it's just about a little bit of difference. Of course, like everyone, Daryl doesn't make much of a rivalry until there's a playoff spot on the line. And I know it's kind of, we've said it time and time again, has to be mentioned, or these teams meet in a playoff series.
Devontae Smith-Pelly took it away and held it in the King zone. Down the left side, Emerson Needham out of Long Beach, California. Ducks still have it. Pass in front. Score! Right in front of the net, Bonino. And it's 1-0 Anaheim.
I'm just talking about the size of Anaheim down low. But this is quickness and speed. And then a long move by Bonino that kind of surprises people. Edom will probably pick up an assist. He chips it right there. Around Muzzin, who gets caught going for the puck. And Bonino with the one long stick handle. All the way, all the way. Good patience by Bonino right there. He let the move make the difference on the play. He didn't overpass it. He didn't overshoot it. He waited till the entire move was well beyond the goaltender's reach. the first time the Ducks are in the offensive zone, it pays off. They lead 1-0.
That's their first shot on goal, and they score on it. Bonino with his first of the year. If Emerson Edom gets an assist, it'll be his first NHL point. Puck comes up the right wing side and brought back out to center ice. Anaheim with it. It's their second game in two nights. Edom does get an assist on it. He's got a lot of friends and family here, of course, growing up in Long Beach. Puck taken by Mike Richards for the Kings. Throws it into the Anaheim zone. Down into the corner. Here's Penner. Penner going for there. He gets checked. Penner's still with it. Checked by Beauchemin. Penner back to the blue line. Scuderi back to the right side to Doughty. Doughty shoots. Tip just wide to the left side. Puck comes back along the left wing boards. Taken by Penner. Penner to Carter. It was Carter that tipped that shot just wide. Here is Richards up the middle. And the Kings can't control it. Taken away by Anaheim and brought back out to center. Penner couldn't hang on to it. Winnick sends it left side. Here's Koivu down in deep. Sharp angle. Threw it back in front and set behind the net. Now back up the middle as Cogliano's shot went behind the net and the puck cleared all the way back into the Anaheim zone. 1-0 Anaheim. Bonino with his first. Edom with the only assist. It came at 2 minutes and 30 seconds into the first period. Puck taken by the Kings. Muzzin back in his own zone. He sends it up on the right wing side and the Kings back into the Anaheim zone. Here's Williams cutting in front. Williams backhander just hit wide. Brown with it. Brown into the corner to Kopitar. Kopitar couldn't hang on. Taken away by Anaheim. Corey Perry, MVP a couple of years ago in the NHL, sends it to the King line and Davis Drewiski breaks it up. Drewiski checked right in front of the Ducks bench. He battles over there along with Bolesky. And who's going to get the puck? The Kings dig it out there and it's flipped down the left side into the Anaheim zone. Chased in by Gagne. Gagne checked there. Goes for the puck again. He's got it behind the net, but his pass going to be taken away by Palmieri. Kings try to get it back. Can't do it. Kyle Palmieri up to center ice. He goes to the left side trying to get around in deep and the shot knocked away by Quick. Palmieri with good speed on the left wing trying to get around Voinov. Puck cleared back out to center ice by Trevor Lewis. Fast-paced game here at Anaheim early in the first period. 1-0 Anaheim leads. Puck comes back out to center ice. Pass on the left side, Kyle Palmieri. Palmieri again checked by Voinov. Palmieri gives it over the right side. Bobby Ryan couldn't hang on. And the Kings take it away and they get it up to Jarrett Stoll.
So far, Bob, the speed on the outside for the Ducks has been very impressive. The pass in the neutral zone, but then enter the zone with speed and keep it simple till the last point, then drive to the net.
Kings back in their own zone, try to break out as they bring it up to center and now to the blue line. Here across the line is Doughty in the slot and offside called against the Kings.
Well, the Kings trying to enter. The Kings had a chance there earlier with Williams coming across, trying to backhand Dustin Brown to the side. You'll see the Kings trying to get the puck alive. Edom right there with the pick. Now watch the lean right there, the lunge. You see that? Bonino had that in the back of his mind. If you get the feel that the defenseman's going to lunge, if you miss with a poke check, the pull and drag work moves right there for Bonino. But if you miss with a poke check, we talk about it mostly with goaltenders, but it works with defensemen too. If you miss the poke check, you're dead because you're off balance. You've got to be in position. You saw right there where Muzzin had the stick going one way and his feet moving at the same time. He was not stable. He was off balance, and Bonino takes advantage.
Ducks have it back in their own zone now. The Ducks so far on the year 4-1-1 for 9 points. They are second in the Pacific Division. They've got it again. Wrap around and score on the wrap around and it's 2-0 Anaheim. Nick Bonino again for his second of the game.
So all the talk I was talking about, the size and the strength and the spin moves down low, the Ducks are just creating turnovers right there. Another steal. And Bonino says, I'll take it myself, take it myself, take it myself. And this one, Quick is just stunned on the play. He's down, but Bonino strips from Doughty. So the second goal scored in similar ways. You can see Bonino stayed on top of it. And for the second time, he kind of kept the puck on his stick longer than expected. The first one was on the backhand. That one right there is on the forehand, and we're going to get a change in goal. Jonathan Bernier will see his first appearance of the season. He's at the Kings bench. He's waiting to get the helmet ready and the mask ready. Normally, you have to be a lot quicker than this. So there's a little bit of a delay. And Daryl Sutter goes, it looks like, with pulling the goaltender. The first one, you have to fault the defenders. Certainly there were turnovers on both goals. One was a stick strip to create a loose puck by Edom. Then it was Bonino just stripping Doughty completely, but then taking it to the front. Quickness and speed and causing turnovers, obviously a big factor to start here. So the Ducks haven't spent a lot of time in the zone. When they have, create the turnover and then take it right to the front of the net.
Well, Bernier and goal, as the Ducks have scored two goals on three shots here in the first period. And the Kings have had trouble all year scoring goals. Are down 2-0. Puck comes to the blue line and across the line, taken by Francois Beauchemin for Anaheim. Jonathan Bernier, his last win March 17th of last season. Puck is back behind the net, picked up there, and the Kings fan on it again. The Kings look out of sync here. Puck comes down into the corner, picked up by Saku Koivu. Koivu's pass into the corner, now back to the right point. Ducks are going to hold it in. Beauchemin sends it back behind the net. Picked up there and taken left wing side by Daniel Winnick to Koivu, and a save by Bernier. So they test him right away, and he makes the save.
And Bob, you just mentioned it. The Ducks once again creating turnovers. The pressure of the Ducks. They're at a different speed than the Kings right now. They have a 2-0 lead. First time this season, Jonathan Quick is on the bench, not for an extra attacker. He's on there because the Ducks have two quick goals. The last one, watch Bonino again. Watch him hold, hold, hold. First goal was backhand, forehand. This on the second goal. It goes off the leg of Scuderi. I don't think it changes directions as much as bounces over top of the stick. You saw Quick had the stick down, paddle down flat. That's the technique. But then it found a way between his legs. I think it bounced over his stick. So it's one of those starts where the Ducks are just taking it. I mentioned they're at a different speed than the Kings.
Yeah,
the Kings'
are.
Defense are getting back. That can be a two-part thing for the Kings' defense. Maybe there's not an outlet. There's no one open at the same time. If there's no one open, you've got to move it quicker. And right now the Kings are holding a split second. And what happens is the turnovers are coming and the Ducks are paying off right now.
So Jonathan Quick plays 5 minutes and 49 seconds, allows two goals on three shots, and he goes to the bench. Jonathan Bernier in goal for the Kings.
He took advantage, Bob, just at the end of the TV timeout. He was in the TV timeout. A lot more stretching than normal, of course. Wasn't expected to be involved in this game, so take advantage of that break to get a little bit more stretching going.
And off the draw here, the puck still in the Kings' zone. Fought for and sent behind the net to Corey Perry. Here's Perry for Anaheim. Perry turns, sent it behind the net again. Back out in front, a loose puck. Ducks jump on it again. Still have it. Right side is Getzlaf. Getzlaf to Perry. Perry checked by Scuderi. Puck comes up the middle and gets by Fowler. Kings chase it down. Fowler trying to get back, and he did, but staying with it is Brown. And it's puck checked off his stick. Picked up by Kopitar. Kopitar, Anaheim zone, back to the blue line to Doughty. Left side is Scuderi. Scuderi shoots wide, rebound off the boards, pinching down is Doughty. Doughty got it behind the net, picked up there by Brown. Over now to Kopitar. Kopitar in the Duck zone. Kings trying to get back in the game. They're down 2-0 early in the game. Puck comes around the left wing corner, and Anaheim goes for it there, but taken away by Brown. Brown got a high stick, it looked like. At least he gave that indication. Let's see if they call it.
Doesn't look like anything right now.
Nothing yet.
No. The referees are coming over to talk to the linesman to maybe confer and see if they missed something on the play. Dustin Brown's looking for something. He had a great chance earlier, using speed on the outside, but then can't foul a young defenseman. He's only 21. Watch Fowler. He gets beat, but then watch recovery. That's half the battle in the NHL. Not the first mistake, but covering up. Look at this stick work. Great position of the stick of Fowler, reaching around Brown. So Brown had the size advantage and won the battle to the puck, but then Fowler said, okay, I can't match the size. Let's go to the smarts. Let's use the stick. It certainly breaks it up.
Fowler, 21 years old, number one pick in 2010 for the Anaheim Ducks. They've closed the penalty box door. No penalty called on that play.
Yeah, they were just trying to figure out where the faceoff was, but Bob, I think they were huddling up to try to get some input from the linesman. Any type of high stick, those types of things. Get together, work it out.
Kings drive it in deep. Here's Lucas Spezza. Spezza for the Ducks, down in the corner. Gagne comes by, trying to get it for the Kings. Spezza still battling with Lewis. And who's going to come out with it? Lucas Spezza. He gets checked in the corner. Lewis had it for a moment. Now here's Gagne. Gagne, he got checked, and the Ducks back to center. Kyle Palmieri. Palmieri tried to feed it off on the right side. Broken up there, but offside called as the Teemu Selänne on the right wing.
Of course, Bruce Boudreau, first full year as head coach of the Ducks. People around Anaheim, Bob, are saying right now the players are buying in. And what they're buying into under Bruce Boudreau is more of a four-line approach and, you know, shorter shifts. And yeah, matchup when you have the matchup, but don't get too locked up in those matchups. And, well, they're buying in. It's working tonight. Who has the two goals? The fourth line.
Boudreau, second among active coaches in the NHL in wins with 232 coming into the game tonight. Coached the Washington Capitals for 4 years. Now the puck taken by Anaheim in their own zone, tipped away, and the Kings hold it in. Nice play there, and a shot wide to the left side as the Kings held it in, but a shot from back near the blue line. Now here's Muzzin. It was Carter that held it in and got the shot. Now behind the net, Penner. Penner, he gets checked and knocked down, and a penalty coming up here for holding against Anaheim.
Well, Penner uses his size. That's what he's talked about. He gets in, shields the puck, and makes Soure reach around, and holding will be the call against the big defenseman. So Penner gets the job done, exactly what he's trying to accomplish out there, and the Kings get the first power play of the game. It's been a sour spot for the Kings, although they do have a power play goal, one in each of the last two games. There's the stick between the legs, kind of the corkscrew, then the push. The free hand is also around the arm of Penner, so holding is that call. Chance for the Kings here to get that power play working, get back in this game.
Kings are 2 of 33 on the power play last. There's a shot up high and off the glass. That shot from back of the blue line by Richards. Penalty killing for Anaheim, not very good. 28th in the league. Doughty sends it off on the right side. It hops over the stick of Kopitar. Back to Richards. Richards hounded by Getzlaf. Now Doughty shoots wide to the right. Rebound to Getzlaf, and he clears to center ice.
That is the biggest sticking point right now with the Ducks, Bob, is that penalty kill, trying to sort things out. A lot of new players. Bruce Boudreau is using a lot of different players, so they're out of sync so far to start this season.
Down in the corner, he put it behind the net, and Allen tried to get to it for Anaheim. Now Allen chases it in again, but the Kings get to it. Pass in front, tipped away. Loose puck taken and not cleared. Held in by Richards with a nice play.
The Kings continue to use four forwards, Bob, here on this power play with Richards back at the blue line.
Doughty gives it over. Here's Brown. He scores! Nice pass by the Kings on that power play. And Dustin Brown puts the Kings on the board. It's 2-1 Anaheim.
I mentioned the power play goals for the Kings in the last two games. They were broken play goals. This is not a broken play. This is a fake shot, pass right there by Doughty. Freezes once. You can see what happens here, Bob. We've been talking about this year. You'll see the shift in the penalty killers. They have to shift once. They can't get back. The lane is wide open. Carter's important right there because big Brian Allen's in front, but Carter occupies a man right down low. Quick puck movement. The puck moving. The players are moving. No one's stopping, and the Kings right back in this game.
Dustin Brown's second goal of the season, and the Kings are down 2-1. See if the Kings can settle down a little bit and counteract that speed of Anaheim. Puck taken by Lucas Pisa. Doughty's going to get one assist on it.
Now Bruce Boudreau, Bob, he goes with a fourth line after the goal, so he's right back with that line. The line has two goals.
Kings back up to center ice. Pass over left side. Gagne moving in. Gagne, pass in front. Saved by Hiller and off the post. Out to the right side. Kings had a chance to tie. Then a shot. Score! Kings have tied it up as the puck came to the top of the right circle. And the goal scored by Jarrett Stoll to tie the game at 2-2.
Now you saw Boudreau upset. The Kings had some life. Gagne, no hesitation. Drive wide. I know he doesn't score, but he really sets the Ducks back on their heels. Right over there, the Ducks try to stand up. Watch this. Doesn't go in the first line. In behind off the post, but then the Kings keep it alive. Great movement once again. High to low to high. That's high, low, high, without stopping the puck twice in a row. No defense is going to be able to stay with that puck moving that quickly, so slow start. Now the Kings right back at it. The third line, Jarrett Stoll, his first of the season.
Kings got two goals in 34 seconds to tie the game. Brown and Stoll. Stoll, as Jim said, with his first of the year. Kings have it again and try to hold it in, but can't do it. Back to center ice. Anaheim with it. Three on three across the line. And Selänne gets leveled by Doughty. Back up to center. Kings come back. Here's Williams moving in. Williams shoots, and he hits the arm of the goaltender Hiller, and then the net gets dislodged. I think, wow, the Kings are going to claim the Ducks knocked the net off purposely.
It does not look like Justin St. Pierre, the referee, is going to make a call, but activity by the Kings. It was all Ducks early. Now it's the Kings. Brown on the power play. Stoll ties it up. We're tied 2-2.
Welcome back. I'm Patrick O'Neill. The Kings have tied things up with the Ducks at 2. Well, tonight's Cold Hard Facts is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light. Now, Jarrett Stoll scoring a goal in his 600th NHL game. Congrats to Jarrett. He's also a great storyteller. He told me some funny ones about head coach Daryl Sutter. Sometimes he showed up at a game without a belt or a tie, and he's had to borrow one from, let's say, Mike Richards because they cost $700 compared to his $300 suit. I'm wondering, Jim, 24 years with Bob, you ever had to get one of those $700 belts?
Maybe if I had
that one.
I'd have 70 belts worth $700, but yeah, Daryl Sutter, he knows quality. He's going after it.
I think I'd go with Sansa belt. Remember those? John Wolf does.
Yes. Inside joke.
Up to center ice to the puck, driven down in behind the net in the King zone, and Kopitar trying to dig it out. We'll catch up on the scoring here. What we've got on the first King goal by Brown, the power play, Kopitar and Doughty at 9:15, then Stoll from Gagne and Lewis. We'll check on those. Here is Kopitar. He shoots wide, rebound out of the reach of Doughty and taken by Getzlaff. He cleared it up ahead and out to center ice. Coming back, Kings take it away. Kings have it back in their own zone. Williams tipped it away, and then Scuderi gave it over to Doughty. So the Kings recovered from a bad start to tie the game at 2-2. Here's Brown. Brown's pass along the boards, held in by Justin Williams. Williams checked there. It's held in by Muzzin. Muzzin right at the blue line. Then a shot and a save and a rebound. Richards goes for the shot by Drewiski. Here's Richards. Richards again for the Kings. Turns his shot up high and into the corner. Chased in by Muzzin. Muzzin tried to poke it down in deep, but it's taken away, and the Ducks control it back in their own zone.
So the Kings continue to put pressure on the offensive zone.
Now taken away. Penner shoots. Deflected wide and out to center ice. All the way back down into the King zone, where Jonathan Bernier, who came on in relief of Jonathan Quick here in the first period, stopped it there, and the Kings' Penner clears it out to center ice, but out of the reach of Carter. Now Penner goes for it, taken away by Koivu. Koivu moving in. Koivu's pass up the middle, shot from there, the save by Bernier, and the shot by Lutman.
Well, another turnover created by the Ducks. This time it's Koivu against Penner, and then they're really attacking the net. That's probably another element that Bruce Boudreau is trying to get everything going. There's the turnover once again. Look at 32 Lutman. He's the guy well behind the play, but Koivu finds him. Great job by Bernier not to overreact to this and just use his crisp one-piece movement across the crease. And then you see with it right there where he finishes up. Well at the top of the crease. He's not a big goaltender, so he has to use position to make saves, and he did there on that last one.
Off the draw here. Shot knocked down and out to center ice. Trevor Lewis chasing it down, but Tony Ludman gets to it. His pass taken away. Pass in front to Lewis, but broken up there as Ludman got back and back to center ice. Devontae Smith-Pelly down the right wing. He's a big body. He goes in deep. Puck taken away by the Kings. Jim, it looks like the Kings have finally got their skating legs and everything else. They look much more composed right now. Now in deep, a shot saved by Hiller on a good bid by Lewis. Puck comes back to the blue line. Taken there by Martinez. Right side, Voinov shoots. Tipped just wide to the right side. And it was tipped by Gagne. Gagne, right wing boards, almost lost it. Then he got it back. And now it comes out to center ice. Kings chase it down. Kings with two goals in 34 seconds. Brown and Stoll. Stoll on the assist there. It's Gagne, and Voinov has been credited with the second assist on that second Kings goal.
Both teams, Bob, are really skating well on the outside. Again, you have to bring it to the net, and both teams are doing that. But the way they're entering the zone, speed on the outside, then crash the front.
Now the Kings drive it down in deep. It's stopped by Hiller. He sweeps it back across the front of the goal crease, and Bobby Ryan chips it out to center, and Brown back to try and get to it. Ducks have it. Long drive wide to the left side, and Doughty took it off the glass. Doughty gets hit hard as the puck comes around the left wing side and out to center ice.
That was Solani finishing on Doughty, of course, earlier. Doughty on Solani.
Here's Bobby Ryan with a shot and a save by Jonathan Bernier.
So the intensity picked up by the Kings starting on the power play. Bernier comes in, settles things down. Just want to keep an eye on Jake Muzzin the rest of the way. Bobby's a young defenseman who was beat on that first one with a lunging poke check that missed. You know, they've talked about Muzzin in the past where his confidence wavers up and down. Very important for a young defenseman. It's very difficult to do, but put that behind you. Makes it easier now that it's 2-2. Now we can concentrate on the rest of the game.
Getzlaf, he's got 2 goals, 4 assists for 6 points on the year. And he's going to take the faceoff for Anaheim here. They're going to kick Colin Fraser out of the faceoff spot. Kyle Clifford comes in for the Kings, and the Ducks win the draw. Here's Corey Perry. Perry down in the corner, King's own. Perry still with it, sent it in front, score to take the lead. Getzlaf right in front on a beautiful pass from Corey Perry. 3-2 Anaheim.
This is more about what I was talking about in the pregame and in the open. The down low, it starts with Corey Perry, though, just beating a man one-on-one. You see the stutter step right there? He beats Martinez. Then the Kings can't get back. Spin and pass all in one motion by Perry. Of course, Perry and Getzlaf know each other like the back of their hands. And Spin doesn't have to look. It's a great play. It's a highly skilled play. It's a world-class play. But it starts with Martinez getting beat in the corner. So something we haven't seen so far this season, Bob, for the Kings, those one-on-one battles being lost or just being beat with a move, it's happened a couple of times, if not more than that, tonight. And the Ducks are making the Kings pay.
5 goals already. That one comes at 13:30. Getzlaf with his first in the last 5 games and his third of the season. And an icing call here against Anaheim. So the Kings were behind 2-0, tied it on goals by Brown and Stoll, but now Getzlaf has given Anaheim the lead.
It's a premium right here. You see that stutter step? Now you don't have that body position anymore. So the contain was not there. Martinez is chasing. If you get body position, you have a chance. Against the Ducks, if you don't get body position, especially against a guy like Perry, you see Pulleski in the crease, so everything working down low, but the pass is pretty. Spin around backhand right on the stick.
Colin Fraser didn't see Getzlaf behind him. He turned around, and there was Getzlaf with the puck, and he put it in the net. Here's Pulleski chasing it down the left side, picked up by Corey Perry. Back to the blue line. Soure. He's got a booming shot from there. This time doesn't get a lot on it. Here is Getzlaf. Getzlaf in the King zone. Getzlaf back behind the net to Perry, falling down. He did well just to get his stick on it, but then the Kings take it away.
He could never get his feet underneath him there to get things moving and get it to the front of the net.
Here's Nolan on the right side of the blue line, and he gets checked right into the linesman and the boards right in front of the Anaheim bench.
I know we've been talking, Bob, about out-of-town scores and teams scoring around the NHL. Now we're getting a little of that ourselves. The Ducks have 8 shots, 3 goals. The Kings have 6 shots, 2 goals. So Ducks going in the net.
Here in the corner, the Kings going for it. There is Drewski. Didn't get it out. And now the Ducks are going to give it away. Taken by the Kings and back across the line. Right side is Lewis. Lewis down into the corner. He gets checked there, but the puck taken away. And a pass in front. Didn't connect. It went off the stick of Stoll. Picked up there and flipped high in the air into the King zone, and Jake Muzzin back to get it. And an icing call.
Well, you have a chance to win an LA Kings authentic Stanley Cup championship ring along with the ultimate Kings fan experience. Visit LAKings.com/raffle. For full details, purchase your tickets today. Tickets are just $2 each, with proceeds benefiting the Kings Care Foundation. Winner will be announced April 25. So get the ring, get the ultimate fan package.
Kings win the draw. Held in the right side by Slava Voynov. Now Justin Williams gets stopped there as the puck is taken by Brian Allen. He's a newcomer this year to the Ducks and cleared out to center and into the King zone. Martinez back to get it. He gives it to Kopitar. Kopitar's pass tipped by Justin Williams into the zone. Brian Allen back to get it. Allen checked by Williams. Kings try to get to it. Kopitar with a check. Puck comes back to the right point. Now left side, Martinez. His shot is blocked. Martinez goes for it again. Couldn't get it. Comes in front to Williams. His shot up high and off the glass. Puck taken by Anaheim. Back to center ice they come. 4:28 to go in the first period. It's been a wild, fast first period. Smith-Pelly puts it deep into the Kings zone. Kings take over. Shoveled up ahead now to center ice to Kopitar. Kopitar's pass intercepted by Palmieri on the right wing. Palmieri shoots wide to the left. Rebound left side. Held in there by Lucas Pisa for Anaheim. Spiza's pass back to the right point. Picked up by Ludman. It tipped in front and a save made. And a rebound. Bonino looking for the hat trick, and it's deflected out of play.
Now the Ducks not backing off at all. Get the puck, keep it moving. A whole bunch of goals scored. The Ducks have 3. The Kings have 2. It's always about the score, but sometimes there's a game within the game. Physical first period for Doughty and Solani. Solani trying to enter the zone. Doughty, good position. Gap control, bang right there, shoulder on shoulder. Then they get together after that hit. A little bit of talking. little chirping, as Drew Doughty would say. Then Solani says, I've got my chance. There it is, shoulder first. Drew Doughty a little chirp back on the way up the ice. So interesting just to watch those two guys. Of course, Doughty excels. He'll be a shutdown guy. He'll be a guy that's out there in those situations. Both guys on the ice right now.
Solani, 42 years old. Doughty, 22 years old. Puck comes into the corner and Doughty with it in the King zone. 3-2 in favor of Anaheim. We're in the first period. Bob Miller along with Jim Fox. Patrick O'Neill with us as the puck comes up. Dan Moriarty with us here tonight in Anaheim. Puck comes down into Carter in the corner. His pass taken away, but he got it back again. Then it rolled off his stick. And Palmieri back to center ice. Gives it on the right wing. And offside called against Anaheim as Solani offside on the right wing.
I still remember, Bob, watching Teemu Selänne play for the first time. I was a broadcaster early in my career. Dave Taylor, of course, was on the ice. Dave's here tonight in attendance, scouting for the St. Louis Blues. After the game, Dave came up to me and said, I have never seen anyone skate as fast as that man. And he really hasn't slowed down at all. I mean, he had that knee injury, what, 3 years ago when he was in Colorado, maybe 4 years ago, and it really bothered him. Of course, he's a skater, so a knee injury is going to bother you. He took some time off, got it 100%, and now it's back to that change of speed, acceleration. So effective.
76 goals as a rookie in 92-93 with the Winnipeg Jets. Teemu Selänne, rookie of the year that year. Not a stretch
what?
To vote for him.
Only 76?
Yeah, right. Puck is cleared up to center ice, and the Kings trying to tie it up for the second time tonight. Puck comes down into the corner, Anaheim zone. Going for there, Gagne along the boards. He got to it. Can he hold it in? He did. Now Stoll. He gets it to Lewis. Lewis checked there. Down into the corner. Kingsway again to Lewis in front. He shoots and a save by Hiller. Lewis again. Tried to throw it in front. Broken up and a check thrown by Stoll for the puck taken by Anaheim. And they get it up the right side to Bolesky and now to center ice. Here's Corey Perry. Perry trying to move in around Doughty. Can't do it. Doughty poke checks it away.
Corey Perry's always showing you three or four different moves at the same time.
Taken away by Anaheim. They keep it in. Cogliano to the blue line. A save made. Left pad save made there on the shot from the blue line. Ludman shoots just wide. A lot of traffic in front of Bernier. And the Kings dig it out and get it up on the left wing side to Carter. Carter chips it off the boards here across the or to the blue line. Clifford, but Nolan just couldn't get back onside.
So Nolan out there because of the physicality. He's been real good this year for the Kings. Out there on the fourth line, Dwight King has been scratched tonight. Dustin Penner back in the lineup. So unusual first period for the Kings as far as the breakdowns defensively and the coverage issues we've seen. We know the Ducks can throw that at you, but I think the Kings are applying what they've talked about offensively. Get the puck to the net. Speed on the outside, but someone's going to the net. And once that man on the outside gets an inch, he's taking it right there.
The Kings had allowed only 7 goals in the last 4 games. That doesn't count shootout goals. So they had been playing well defensively, but they give up 3 here in the first period tonight. 2 minutes left to go in the first period. Here's Kopitar to center. Kopitar feeds it on the left side to Brown. Brown with a golden night. His shot knocked down. Brown again. Save and the rebound wide to the right. And Brown gets knocked into Hiller. Puck comes back to center. 3-on-2 for the Anaheim Ducks. Right side. Pass over on the left wing side. Picked up there down in the corner by Daniel Winnick. Winnick has had a really fast start. Winnick coming over, a newcomer this year. And the Kings bring it back across. A shot off the boards wide by Martinez. Martinez put it down in deep, and the Kings want to change lines. Winnick, 5 goals leading the Anaheim Ducks in goals coming into the game tonight. Now the Kings with it at their own blue line. Minute 15 to go here in the first period. Puck taken by Drewiski. Drewiski jumping down the left side. Penalty coming up here. Interference is the call.
Now defensemen are talking about this, Bob. I know you mentioned it way back in the first game we televised where, you know, Rob Scuderi's been talking about it. It's that dump in, same side chip. You have to make contact immediately. If not, the referees have been very, very strict in this area. You see the dump in here by Drewiski, and there's not much time at all. So that's a strict interpretation. Beauchemin did stand up right away, and he tried to make the play right away, but the referee felt too much time had elapsed there. So another chance for the Kings to get it going. Again, 4 forwards for the Kings on the power play. A couple of games ago, they were going with normal line combinations up front. where they keep this three guys together, keep it rolling like that. Carter, Kopitar, Brown up front for the Kings.
Beaujolais for interference at 18:50, and the Kings on a power play trying to tie it up. Carter shoots and a save. Brown right in front, but the save made by Hiller. The other penalty this year that players seem to really have trouble with, it was called in the Colorado game today, putting your hand on top of the puck. It's not closing your hand. You can't put your hand on top of the puck.
Yeah, there's a lot of players in the past, Bob, even though they didn't close their hand, they would control where the puck was going. And, of course, then you're hiding it from everyone, so cracking down on that. The Kings' first power play goal, you could not draw up any better. The movement, the quickness, the bodies back and forth in a wide-open net. The skill guys at top speed executing. We'll see if the Kings can continue that here.
Kings are 1-on-1 on the power play. Time running out in the first period. Only 43 seconds left to go in the period. Puck is set around the boards. Carter knocks it down. Kopitar helps, and Getzlaf tried to clear. He couldn't do it. Kings hold it in. Brown shoots on a save by Hiller and a rebound. Picked up there by Saray. Back out to the right point. Richards with it there. Richards with 26 seconds to go on the power play. He gets it down the right side. Here's Brown in the corner. His pass deflected up out of play with 21.2 seconds to go in the first.
And again, I think the Kings are trying to apply what they've been talking about, that they are shooting more. They're getting the puck in positions where they're not waiting for the perfect shot. Now, Brown's goal was a perfect play. But sometimes that is set up because you're just willing to take the shot, willing to get the defense back on their heels. Then after that, make some passes.
Jarrett Stoll will take the faceoff, which stays in the Anaheim zone because the Ducks deflected it out of play. 3-2 Anaheim. Ready on the draw. Kings with a power play. Kings win the faceoff. Back to Doughty at the right point. He slides it over to Voinov. Back to Doughty. Doughty feeds it right side. Gets it back. Doughty shoots. Blocked in front. And back out to center ice. And Doughty has to chase it down. 6 seconds to go in the period. Here's Doughty. Across the blue line. He gets hit there and knocked down. And that is the end of the first period. And now a punch thrown there by one of the Anaheim Ducks, and he's going to get a penalty, too.
He might, yeah. The referee, Brad Watson, is pointing at him.
Yep.
He may be warning him. We'll see.
Ryan Allen.
He took a punch right by him. Now, he leveled Doughty. Doughty tried to enter at top speed, and Allen did his job initially, but then the Kings were kind of skating around. It looks like the referee is skating across, and I think he's going to have Allen off. So the Kings will have a two-man advantage if it turns out the way we think. Here's the initial contact. Nothing wrong there. Nothing at all, but then the Kings kind of hang around. You see Allen? Doughty's going down because he knows he's going to get hit, then loses an edge on the play. But then when the players came together again, there was pushing and shoving and maybe a punch over the top. If there is a penalty given, there's still 50 seconds remaining on Beauchemin's penalty. That means the Kings would have a two-man advantage.
During the lockout, Andrei Kopitar and Bobby Ryan played together in Sweden as teammates. Now they're rivals. We'll take a look at that after this.
Welcome back once again. One period down, a lot of goals. Three for the Ducks, two for the Kings. Drew Doughty was involved at the end of that first period, and Brian Allen did pick up a roughing call. So it's going to be a two-man advantage for the Kings for at least 50 seconds here to start. There's Allen in the box, and when the referees came on, Bruce Boudreau had a big discussion with them trying to figure out things out, but the hit was not the issue. It was right there. That's the issue. The punch thrown against Justin Williams, and the referee was standing just off to the side. And that's the reason. So huge chance here for the Kings to get it going. They have their goal on the power play to start this game. They're right back within one. Now looking for the 5-on-3.
Kings are 0-for-4 with a two-man advantage this year, and as we have said twice, they've had a full 2 minutes on it. So now they puck driven down into the Kings zone. Kings with a chance to tie it up. They're down 3-2. Second period underway. Kings with a two-man advantage. Here's Doughty. Doughty across the line and staying onside, dragging his foot, was Carter. Richards sends it across left side to Kopitar. Kopitar's out at the left point now. He puts it down and deep, gets it back again, doesn't take the shot, gives it to Doughty. Doughty to Kopitar. Kopitar turns, crisscrosses with Doughty, shoots, blocked, picked up by the Kings and held in. Here's Doughty again. Doughty got it from Kopitar. Doughty put it down in deep, a pass in front, and a loose puck swept out the center ice. Carter tried to get there in time, couldn't do it. Now Kopitar gives it to Carter. Carter drops it back. Now it's a one-man advantage. Here's Kopitar. Kopitar back over to Doughty. Doughty waits and almost lost it. Can he get there in time? Yes, he holds it in. Doughty at the left point. Doughty over to Richards. A one-man advantage for the Kings. Puck comes over to Kopitar. Kopitar with it. Kopitar's pass taken away. Can he get it back? And it is fought for along the boards, held in by the Kings. Richards over to Doughty. Doughty shoots, save, rebound, score! Brown to tie the game. Dustin Brown with his second of the night, and we're tied 3-3. Kings' second power play goal of the game.
The Kings lost the faceoff to start the period, so they actually took them 30 seconds to get in the zone. But this is simplified hockey, and Dustin Brown is proving he's getting a little timing back, because this takes timing here. Of course, he has the position to screen the goaltender, and that probably is the reason there's a rebound here. It's not a hard shot, but because the goaltender can't come out, can't be aggressive because of Brown's position, then the rebound. Watch the timing. Of course, he scored at Staples Center last game with a bounce off the glass, but the timing's coming back. Shot, rebound, simplified front net presence. Kings tied up 3-3.
Brown with two goals in the game. Bonino with two goals in the game for Anaheim. Kings with two power play goals, both by Brown, and the Kings have tied it up. Kings with it again. Pass by Martinez, gets it back again. Fanned on his shot, and back to center ice come the mighty, or come the Ducks. Down the left wing side, Valesky goes down into the corner. He gets checked there in the King zone. Puck is dug out by Getzlaf. Getzlaf to the blue line. He throws it off on the right wing, and it's taken away by Alec Martinez. Martinez up ahead to Lewis. Lewis, checked by Getzlaf, throws it in deep. Chased down, Kings with it, and into the corner. Getting knocked down there, and sliding into the corner is the puck comes all the way back in, almost looking for a moment like maybe the skates got tipped out from underneath the Kings player. Taken by Ludman. Ludman lost it to Richards. He shoots, save, rebound sent wide. Nice play by Richards to pickpocket the Tony Ludman of Anaheim, but then his shot went wide, and now it hops up out of play.
Now completely different. The way the game was started, the Ducks were creating turnovers. Now it's the Kings, and Mike Richards with a strip. Ludman back, not necessarily pressured initially, but he doesn't get body position. Then the rebound becomes an issue too, so the Kings are all over the Ducks at this point. Richards with a steal. Big Jeff Carter with a putback. You saw Ludman just hesitate. When you're a defenseman in that situation, much like the Kings in the first, if you don't have a man, you've got to move it. Got to move it quick. If not, you're going to get stripped.
The goal by Brown, assisted by Doughty and Richards at 1:15 of this second period, and the Kings have tied it up. Shot is wide to the right side by Doughty. Now the Kings in the zone, try to get it to Kopitar in front. Comes through to Doughty at the right point. Doughty sends it back behind the net. Kings still with it, trying to take the lead for the first time tonight. Puck dropped off in the corner. Now go Kings go, the chant. The crowd pretty well split here at Anaheim, as it usually is. Sometimes even more Kings fans than Ducks fans. Here is Kopitar. Kopitar's pass tipped in the corner and taken away by the Ducks. But the Kings trying to hold it in, and Doughty does. Doughty sends it in deep to Williams. Williams back over to Kopitar. Kopitar's pass intercepted, but a nice check along the wall, and the Kings hold it in again. Check by Brown, and he held it in. Now the Ducks get it up ahead to center ice. Taken there and fired in by Bobby Ryan back behind the net.
Smart positioning by Dustin Brown. That was Solani. If Solani gets the top speed, he's trouble. But Brown, perfectly with the shoulder, takes him out, rubs him out, slows him down. And, you know, Dustin Brown is known for hard hits. This was just an effective hit. Again, you sense the situation with Solani. Jeep will show us that Brown says, okay, right there, just get the body position first. It doesn't have to be hard, but it's certainly effective. And it's a pretty good start to this period. Now, a little talking here after that last whistle. Keep in mind, because of that roughing, it was a clear-cut punch by Allen to Williams, and that's the reason he went off. But the referees are proving already they're going to call it strict, so no extra after whistles. If so, you're going to go to the box.
Kings have outshot the Ducks 5-0 here in this second period. And tie the game at 3-3. Now we get a scrap going. We've got Ryan Allen and Nolan.
Wow, both guys willing to throw it. Of course, Allen is huge. 6'5", Bob, with Allen. So he's got the length and reach. Now, Jordan has length and reach also. And it's one of those, of course. Jordan's thinking about the punch that Allen threw at Williams. He's also just thinking about the job he has to do at times. And for big guys, Bob, that was one of those where they weren't looking to dance. They were looking to throw. When you're that big sometimes, you have to kind of go in cautiously, because the haymakers are being thrown. We still have a duck down in the far corner. I think it's Cam Fowler down. So that's not good news for Anaheim. It might be. Yeah, it is Fowler. So, yeah. Whoa.
Spoozy.
Wow. Okay, now, because of what happened there when he got up, you see the trainer is right there. That's a concern. You see Boschman over to help out. So perhaps didn't initially see. Wow. The Cam is still struggling. Right off the faceoff. We'll see the Kings end up getting it down low. So you have the big bodies out there with Clifford. You have Nolan. They're right there. So no, you know. Now in the far corner, it looked like Clifford was starting a forecheck against Fowler. Bury the head and throw. Allen went down first, but then Nolan went down later. So the dump-in was created to get things going. And of course, the fight takes place on the other side. But maybe we'll see what happens. Stoll chasing Fowler. Fowler tries to stop. And then you have referee bowling. We've seen that a couple times this year. The ref goes down, but Fowler looks like he's shaken up.
I wonder if he hit his head on the lip of the boards that come out there, because he was headed that way and then got knocked down. Play underway again. Kings get it back to the right point. Here's Downey, played it off the boards. He shoots. It's deflected wide. Penner was right in front of the net. Now Penner can't get it behind the net. Now it comes out in front, but played up the left side by Soure. So Brian Allen, he's a free agent signed here from Carolina last year. So his first year with the Ducks here in Anaheim. Puck is picked up by Anaheim across the line. Right side, Corey Perry, and it just rolled away, and he's checked there by Scuderi. Back to the blue line. Soure, his shot, blocked, and the Kings can't clear. Comes down into the corner, and Perry put it behind the net. Koleski got caught up in the back of the net, and the puck taken by Scuderi, but his pass intercepted. Perry shoots, blocked by Doughty, sliding in front. He gets up, and he's got the puck. Here's Doughty across the blue line and offside. He just didn't get far enough across there with the puck.
Well, there's world-class skill. He played with Perry on the Canadian Olympic team, so he knows a little bit about him. Watch Perry just hang back there. Hang back in the quiet zone. Sprawling to block down and up. The sense of where that puck is. Again, with Doughty, he doesn't have to look. He doesn't have to figure out where it is. He just senses where it is, and then right away to top speed to go the other way.
Doughty, 29 minutes a game he is spending on the ice. Kings have it at center ice, and it's driven in by Drewiski.
And those are 29 active minutes. They're not just kind of right. Watching out there. He's always making something happen.
Anaheim with it. Pass up to center ice. Chased down the right side by Winnick. He's cutting in. He shoots, and a glove save by Bernier. And then Bernier gets bumped. So things are heating up here a little bit. Winnick's had the hot hand for Anaheim.
We'll see. The referees, again, have been very strict in these areas. So both refs are right there, and they're watching. See Brad Watson. He has the orange armbands. He's there. St. Pierre is right in the slot. A nice stretch pass off the boards here. Breaks Winnick free. Now, Jake Muzzin is the Kings defenseman who gets caught flat-footed again. So you see the Ducks, you can't go stick-to-stick. You go off the boards and behind. And Muzzin didn't anticipate that type of pass. Bernier holds on. And then we had a little bit of chirping there after the whistle. Not too much. No penalties called, but good use of the boards by the Ducks. If you can't go stick-to-stick, and again, just that anticipation. Muzzin didn't pick up the pass and couldn't get to the man.
That was the Ducks' first shot of the period. We've got 15-11 to go in the period. Loose puck is taken by Clifford, but he couldn't clear it out. Ryan with a shot, knocked down. Solani goes for it in the corner. He gets help from Ryan. Solani again. Solani in the King zone, tried to give it into Ryan. Ryan gets spun around, and then he falls down. Puck comes up to center. Fans wanted a penalty against the Kings. Here's Clifford tipping it into the Anaheim zone. Clifford down the corner. He gets checked there. Spins away, looks for a pass. Stoll lost his stick, and along the boards, Clifford with a check, but the Ducks bring it out to center ice. Taken away nicely by Lewis at the blue line. Now the Kings have it, and back they come to center. Here's Lewis across the line. Trevor Lewis down the left side. He gets checked there. Puck is centered in front. They had Kopitar right there if he could have gotten the pass. Now a shot and a save by Hiller on the shot from back near the blue line by Drewiski.
So the Kings get a change, and you get the fresh players on the ice, and then you sustain pressure. And That last shot was by Williams, and I talked with Justin Williams this morning at the morning skate, Bob, and he said, you know, he's struggling offensively, but what he said was just simplify. And you hear that all the time from players. For him, though, he admitted, he says his legs still don't feel like they're there yet. But that last play, just get it to the net, and he feels like he's getting close. And certainly his line is coming together with Kopitar and Brown.
Face-off here, Kopitar with Getzlaf. Puck comes along the boards. Kopitar trying to dig it out. It comes free behind the net. Getzlaf pokes it ahead, and Anaheim with it in their own zone. Next Tuesday night, Kings will be at Columbus against the Blue Jackets. They beat Detroit today. Puck taken by Anaheim. We'll be on the air 3:30 in Southern California with the pregame show from Columbus next Tuesday. Getzlaf gets away from a check. Getzlaf, his pass in front, tipped and taken away by Scuderi. Now up to center ice. Here's Kopitar. Kopitar across the line in the zone. Kopitar driving in front. He couldn't take the puck with him. It went behind the net. And the Anaheim Ducks have it. It's cleared up ahead to center ice and down into the King zone. A bouncer, but offside. Going to be called here. 13:34 to go. Second period. Kings have tied it for the second time tonight. It's 3-3.
At practice yesterday, Andre Kopitar told me the Kings need more bodies to the net. Well, on the last shift, he takes it wide against Soure. Looks like he's going behind. I've seen this from both teams tonight. Doesn't work here, doesn't get the puck to the front, but he gets the body to the front at the last second, tries to cut in. So both teams have been trying that, but Kopitar said it yesterday, comes to the game, puts it into practice. Get the bodies to the front.
Kings points in their last four games, 2-0-2. Anaheim 2-0-1 in their last three games. Puck is in the Anaheim zone and taken by Penner. Penner on the left side. Penner's still with it. Penner's pass up the middle, but it went right there and taken by Cogliano, who intercepted, and he chased it down in the King zone. He gets checked there along the boards. Richard stepped into him, and the puck taken by the Kings, and it is chipped off the boards out to center ice by Carter. Anaheim back to get it. Ducks long pass up the center and just off the stick there as it came down the left side. Saku Koivu was all the way back at the King blue line. That long pass just about connected, then it came up out of play.
Well, Bob, we've seen Soraya in the last play there with Kopitar trying wide. Allen to the penalty box because of the scrap. If there's anything different to me this year about the Ducks, it's the addition of those two defensemen. It's a different vibe for Anaheim. Soure, there he is, that 6'4", Allen, 6'5". They're not fast guys, but they're big. They can be physical. They can change the complexion of a game with that size. That's something I think the Ducks did not have last year.
Four newcomers they signed, Brian Allen, Sheldon Soure, Brad Staubitz, and Daniel Winnick. Puck is in the King zone and chased down along the boards there and picked up by Stoll. Stoll got it up ahead to center to Lewis. Here's Lewis across the line. Lewis in the middle. In front now, Voinoff shoots, and it's just tipped wide to the left.
Voinoff was open on the play. Lewis didn't see him, but Voinoff said, I'll keep going. He kept going. He was right there for a loose puck.
Now the Ducks get it up ahead to Luca Spezza. Spezza, he gets cut off there. Spezza out of Italy, the number one pick of Philadelphia in 2008. Over to Devante Smith-Pelly, but he can't hang on. And it's taken by the Kings, and Gagne got it out to center, but out of the reach of Stoll. Ducks back in to get it. Tony Ludman, he sat out the game last night. Vatanen, the rookie, played for Anaheim, and now he's out tonight, and Ludman is back in. Here is Scuderi. His pass taken by the Kings. They come back to center ice. Three on three across the line. Drop pass to Williams. Pope checked away there and taken by Anaheim.
There's a veteran NHL defenseman not backing off. Pressure all the way. Beauchemin, outnumbered situation. Very aggressive to break it up.
Kings back with it again, and a hard check thrown there as Brown came across the blue line, down deep into the King zone and taken by Doughty. Doughty got stopped, and a penalty to the Kings coming up here.
It's going to be Kopitar. He knows it. Second game in a row. He knows he's guilty with a stick into the skates. Chance by the Kings was by Voinoff, defenseman joining the play. Then a great stand-up by Beauchemin. So the Ducks making sure they're helping out. Here's that player. Look at 26. He's joining. There's Voinoff. He's open. But then he says, I'm going to go. Stays to the backhand there. End of the last shift. There's Beauchemin standing up. It was a play Beauchemin made earlier that really impressed me, because the Kings had speed on a 3-on-2. And when Beauchemin came across, He was so aggressive. He went right at Justin Williams. I think he surprised Williams. I think Williams thought he was going to back off. There's Williams talking with Dustin Brown on the bench, and that really surprised him. Didn't have time to make the move. Right now, Anaheim looking to take the lead again. Man advantage.
It's their first power play of the night for Anaheim. They're 12th in the NHL. Puck comes on the left-wing side of the King zone. And the puck comes out to center ice. They thought somebody was at the left point, but they weren't. And Getzlaf's pass came out, and Soray had to chase it down. Now Getzlaf comes across the line. Poke checked away from him, back out to center ice. Lewis trying to get to it. Taken away there by Soray to Getzlaf. Right side it goes, and a shot is wide to the left, and the rebound held in by Getzlaf. Getzlaf all the way back to the blue line. He feeds it off of the right side. He gets it back again on the power play. Shoots, and Bernier with a save.
Able to see it, able to make sure no second chance. You have Getzlaf way out. He's a forward here, obviously, but he's way out to buy himself some room. Look at him. He's right at the blue line. So he's going to just get it through. We'll see the boxing out by the Kings. You have the position in front. And there's Gillespie just trying to get in the way. At the last second, though, Bernier able to look around the screener. That's very important because with a high shot, he made sure he took it to his chest. If there's a rebound there, it's dangerous.
Anaheim is 4 out of 17 on the power play so far this season. They've got it again in the King zone. The game is tied at 3. Anaheim with a power play for another minute 15, held in by Sheldon Soray. Soray's pass into Corey Perry, taken away by Scuderi. Can he clear? No. Getzlaf gets over to hold it in. Getzlaf put it down into the corner. Beaujolais tried to hold it in. He did. Now poked in and getting knocked down was Doughty. Loose puck in front, up the middle. Shot by Soray. Score! And Anaheim takes the lead once again at 4-3. Soray got the shot. There was traffic in front of Bernier.
There's one thing you know about Soray, and that's his shot. That's a given. That might be his biggest asset. We'll see here with Doughty. Looks like Doughty gets caught with a stick into the skates. And the no call, look at the traffic. Actually, you know what? At the time of the shot, it did not look like anyone's in front. We'll see here. It's only Kings. You'll see that Bernier does get a piece, but it's 7-hole. Because Soray shoots it so hard, it just sneaks through. That was a great look, guys, at eye level to get right down there in behind the shooter. So it did open up. It wasn't necessarily a screen. But certainly the velocity becomes an issue. A defenseman like Soray who can bring it with that much time to load up. And the Ducks regain that one goal lead.
Soray signs a free agent from Dallas, and he gets his second goal of the season. Power play goal, and Anaheim has the lead once again. They've led 2-0, 3-2, and now 4-3. Puck is in the Anaheim zone, and they get it up the left wing side now to Andrew Cogliano. Cogliano throws it down in deep, chased in by Daniel Winnick. Winnick checked down to the corner. Kings try to dig it out as Koivu comes in for Anaheim. Centering pass intercepted. Kings get it to Kopitar, and across the ice it goes to Brown. Brown's got two goals tonight. He flips it into the right wing corner of the Anaheim zone, and the Ducks back to pick it up. Kings take it away at the blue line. They hold it in. Clifford going for it. Clifford checked there by Allen. Puck comes around and chopped at and bounced down, and Drewiski goes for it. Then a hard check there as Clifford came over, and the puck down in the corner. Stoll. Stoll going for it. Now Clifford, look out, maybe getting into a little something here with Koivu, and a high sticking penalty.
That's the call. That was blown down when the Ducks had it. But there may have been a delay on it. It looks like Koivu's going to the box, so the Ducks regain a one-goal lead. Looks like the Kings going to go back on the power play. Hard hit by Clifford to keep things going. He's been so effective this year. Kings man advantage coming up. But right after the break, Patrick O'Neill on the bench with Trevor Lewis.
Welcome back. Trevor Lewis joins me right now. A real physical game. Is the most physical game you've had this year?
It's always physical against these guys. They got a big team. But we got to get back on the body and establish our game.
We have a chance on the power play. Are you guys getting enough traffic in front of the net that you've seen in this game?
I think we're getting better as the game goes on. But We got to get more shots through and get more bodies to the net and get some ugly ones.
All right, Louis, thank you. Okay, Bob, Jim, back to you.
And a shot from the left side off the glove there of the goaltender as Hiller made the stop. Kings on the power play, but it gets by Doughty all the way back in the Kings zone.
That time, Doughty had all kinds of time and all kinds of room, elected to go with the wrist shot to get it through and just a piece of the glove, but the Kings are finding open men with the man advantage.
Koivu for high sticking at 10:40. Kings are 2 out of 3 on the power play. Here's Kopitar, skids to a stop to Doughty, and his shot wide off the board, so the left point to Richards. Richards gives it to Carter. Carter check there, slaps it in deep. Sheldon Surrey goes for it, and nice play by Doughty. He knocked it down to the blue line. Doughty holds it in. Doughty slides it left side. Here's Richards. Richards in front, and a loose puck taken away as Richards passed it in front, but it didn't connect, and then cleared by Anaheim.
Yeah, it was kind of a changeup there by Richards. He had the big cock of the stick way back and high, and he was going through, but he decided just to throw it softly to the front.
And the Kings go offside at the blue line of Anaheim.
A little disruption right there for the most part. The Kings getting those bodies there, getting the opportunities. Doughty, you see, upset. He had time on that first wrist shot, so certainly the Kings so effective tonight with a man advantage. And now they're getting the movement. Now they're getting men free with time. That's the important thing. You get time to a skilled player, it's going to make something happen.
Kings win the draw. It's out at the King blue line. Here's Slava Voynov with it now. 49 seconds left to go on the King power play. Pass on the right wing, cutting in, is stole. He shoots, and a save by Jonas Hiller.
Well, take the shot. Again, that's the things the Kings have been talking about. A lot of times on power plays, right there, you take it wide, you set it up. And, well, you know what? The way things have been going, now the Kings are turning around. Keep going. Keep throwing it to the net and just hope. Sometimes the goaltender makes a mistake. Doesn't have to be for a goal. Could be for a rebound.
Faceoff will be in the Anaheim zone. Jarrett Stoll moving in for the Kings. Kings still on the power play. 44 more seconds. And who's got the loose puck? It's loose in the circle. Kings dig it out. They get it back to Voynov. Voynov slides it left side. Shot by Muzzin. Knocked down in front. Loose puck. Kings with it. Gagne shoots. Picked up by Muzzin. He shoots and it's wide. Gagne. Now we got a whistle now that was deflected out of play. I don't know if the first shot hit the post. Came out pretty quick.
You know what? It's a shooting gallery and it's impressive. And it's just a... You know, you got to finish. The Kings now with 4 shots that have gotten through and on the net. So you see the one-step shot by Muzzin, not looking to score. If there's been a change in the game, Bob, and it's so difficult, I don't know. Hockey's the only sport I'm aware of where you're talking about shooting, not to score. And that's the way it is now, right now with goaltenders, especially in this situation. Shoot for the rebound.
Kings with it again, still on the power play. Here's Doughty, moves it left side, and back to Doughty, top of the slot. 20 seconds to go on the power play. Shot up high over the net, picked up by Brown. Back out to Doughty. Doughty, left side. He feeds it down the left side here in deep. In front was Carter. Carter had his helmet knocked off. Puck is taken now by Brown. Brown gives it to Doughty. Doughty still with it. Back over left side. Brown looking for the hat trick. Shoots. It's blocked. Brown gets held up and out of the penalty box is Koivu. Koivu gets it on the right wing. Koivu's pass. Left side. And a shot from there. Tipped wide to the right. The shot by Brian Allen. Kings have it. And Carter without a helmet moves it up ahead to Brown. Brown across the line. Brown's pass over to Kopitar. Kopitar down the corner. He gets checked there. And the Ducks dig it out and get it back to center ice. They get it to Solani. Picked up now. And Kings have it back in their own zone. Drewiski dropped it off in the corner. Now here's Nolan for the Kings. He got it back across the blue line to center ice. 6:40 to go in the second period. The Kings trailing 4-3 to Anaheim. Puck cleared up the left side. Kings with it. Clifford's pass. Now taken to center by Davis, Drewiski. Drewiski checked by Palmieri. Drewiski's pass comes all the way back behind the Anaheim net. Cut off there by Jonas Hiller. Pass up the middle. The Kings couldn't hold it in. Clifford tried. It came all the way back to the King line, and then Scuderi sends it in deep. Bernier has played 2 previous games against Anaheim and won them both. He came on in relief of Jonathan Quick back in the first period. Now a pass left wing side taken by Martinez. Shots in this period, the Kings 12, Anaheim 3, but Anaheim leads 4-3. They score the power play goal. Puck is in the Anaheim zone. Back behind the net. Backhander. Score! Justin Williams with a beautiful backhander. And it's tied 4-4.
I told him this morning, Bob, I said, Willie, you got one. And he said his approach was grind and shoot. This is not pretty until the end. It just grinded out. You keep it alive the first time. Guy, you watch one step right to the top. It goes off the shoulder of the goaltender, then off the arm. Hiller knows he's in trouble. He's down, up, up, up. It's still not going in until, watch this. Because he doesn't know where it is, he's trying to get his body against the post and crossbar, but it's too late. The puck's already in behind, off his back, drops in behind. You have to consider that one of those bad type of goals because of the angle. And the Kings tied up 4-4.
But it's a good one right here. Williams gets his first of the year, and as Jim said, we are tied again 4-4. Here's Bernier. Look out. He almost lost it behind, and then a pass is tipped away into the corner. Kings a little sloppy play in their own zone right here.
It's going to turn into a penalty. But it looks like, yeah, that's what happened, Bob. And you're right, you know, it's unusual. The Kings have scored four. That's unusual. They've allowed four because of breakdowns in the defensive zone. Now the Kings are going to the box. Justin Williams ties it up. Be right back. Well, the grind and shoot approach works for Justin Williams. Again, keeping it alive once. We'll see overhead what happens. It hits the blocker of Hiller here. Low, goes high, off the crossbar. Then his other arm comes in behind as he's trying to jam his body. By that time, it's too late. Jordan Nolan reaches right there, grabs the arm. Docito, let's go right away. Got enough of Winnick. He goes to the box.
So now Anaheim on the power play, but the Kings come out with it. Here's Richards, one-on-one. He shoots and a save. Richards again. Couldn't get to it in time to get a good shot. Hiller was kind of nonchalant, just leaving it lie there in front of the net. The game has been tied for the fourth time. It's 4-4. Puck passed and Karam's back out to center ice.
They took that breakdowns, Bob, because they look at the shot totals. Only 14 shots for the Ducks so far, but they have four goals out of that.
Kings chase it down on the right side. They come to center 2-on-2. Here's Carter. He feeds it over on the left wing side, gets a return pass from Richards. Carter had to go into the corner to get it. Carter in the Anaheim zone trying to hold it in along the boards and dug out by Anaheim.
I mentioned the other night, that's when you get the indication that Mike Richards is on his game or getting better. When he starts creating chances shorthanded, he's excellent right there.
Bernier stops the puck and then tried to clear it himself. He got it up the slot and then it sent the rest of the way to center ice by Kopitar. Williams getting his first goal of the year to tie the game. Gagne and Stoll with the assist at 14-12 of this second period. 48 seconds left to go in the King penalty. Anaheim with it back in their own zone. Now to center, Saku Koivu. Koivu sends it over to Spezza. Bernier cut it off, got it around to Lewis. Lewis trying to clear, had to reach out for it, didn't get it. Here's Koivu. Koivu back to the blue line. Left point, it goes to Beaujolais. Back up the middle. Now Koivu, right side, in front, score! The tie to take the lead. Power play goal, Palmieri, right in the slot. And the Kings just failed to get a stick on it to clear it. And it winds up in the King net. 5-4 Anaheim.
The story of the game tonight, for the Kings at least, is one mistake goal. That's what's happening. Unable to get it out, then it's perfect execution by the Ducks. One touch passing, right there's the last one. And Palmieri is just set up perfect. And he tags it. I mean, he really does. But the setup is perfect. The shot, the pass is right in the wheelhouse. Palmieri just has to load it up. You talk about transfer of weight. He just loads it up and comes through as hard as possible. That all started, though, Bob. You mentioned the Kings had a chance to get it out. Just a half inch away, couldn't get it out. Comes back to kill him.
Now Brown chases it down in the Anaheim zone. Palmieri gets his fourth goal of the year. He's second on the team in goals to Daniel Winnick. Another power play goal for Anaheim. And the Kings trail again. 5-4. The Kings have never led in the game, but they have battled back four times to tie. Now they've got to do it again. Back up to center ice. Here's Brown. He's got two goals tonight. Chopped away from him. Taken by Anaheim. Winnick steps across the line and sends it in deep. Back behind the net. Brown goes for it, gets it back over to Voinov. And Brown got dumped and the Kings come to center. Here's Kopitar. He flipped it up in the air into the Anaheim zone. Kings want to get a line change here. Sheldon Surrey in to get it. Gagne on the ice for the Kings now. Along with Richards up front. Richards tried to pick it up. Now it's taken by Penner. Penner stole it. Penner down the middle. tipped off of his stick, played by the Kings. Richards to the blue line. Drewinski shoots. It's wide to the left. Pinching down in, and a shot off the glove of Hiller. The shot there by Martinez, and Hiller covers up for the faceoff.
We'll get back to the goal by the Ducks. Palmieri in perfect position, but initially the Kings have it. Not total control by any means. One try here. Good pinch along the boards. Can't get it the second time. Good player by Koivu. All the way back in one motion. And it's going to be Koivu with a one touch right there. That's just a perfect pass. Palmieri has to like it. And they executed perfectly. Again, it wasn't a clear-cut breakdown by the Kings. It's good pressure by the Ducks to keep that puck alive.
Koivu and Spisa with the assist on the goal by Palmieri that gives the Ducks a 5-4 lead. Kings have it. Here's Williams. Williams down the right side. He's got a goal tonight. He throws it in front. Comes wide to the left and a shot up high off the glass. And the puck taken by Anaheim and cleared up to center ice. The shot was by Scuderi that went up high, and now it's tipped up out of play into the Anaheim bench.
A reminder that upcoming later on, Patrick O'Neill will have the Carl's Jr. Sports Update. Just take a look around the National Hockey League, some developing stories, so checked out a little bit later. So 16 shots for the Ducks, 5 goals, 26 shots for the Kings, 4 goals, and at least it has been a wide open game. It's been entertaining, and the shots have been pretty good. Hard shots, accurate shots, good passing, one touch passing. You move the puck quick and it ends up in the net.
Well, it's been an exciting game, and there's still a period left to go after this one. 2:09 to go here in the second. Doughty sends it down and deep. He leads Stoll. Stoll sends it back over to Williams. Williams, he gets checked along the boards there. Williams on the right wing side. He gets some help. Kings dig it out. Here's Kyle Clifford. Clifford backhands it down along the boards to Williams. Williams still with it. Zigzags to the blue line. Williams pass over on the left side. Taken by Scuderi. Shoots just wide. Rebound off of the right side to Stoll. Stoll put it behind the net. Clifford. Clifford to Williams. Back out to Scuderi. Scuderi to Doughty. Doughty back to Scuderi. Scuderi waits, shoots, blocked in front, and cleared by the Ducks up to the blue line and taken there back up to center ice by Bolesky. His drive and a pad save by Bernier. Bolesky again now, a pass in front. Bolesky didn't get to it in time, but Perry did. Now the Kings back to center. Here's Jordan Nolan. Nolan down the right side. He got flipped pretty high there as he flipped it in. Puck comes back out to center and all the way back into the King zone. Chased down in deep by the speedy Palmieri, and he gets checked there by Voinov. Kings get it back to the blue line and not out across the line yet. Now Voinov with a minute to go in the second period. Sends it deep into the Anaheim zone, and an icing call going to be called here.
A little scrambly right now, so it's up to the Kings to get the forecheck working once again. Try to get big bodies. Keep in mind, Bob, I don't believe Cam Fowler is back since he went down after that hard hit, and he was shaken up, and you could tell he was a little bit woozy, so probably don't expect him back. The Ducks are in a back-to-back. They played last night. They won a game here at Honda Center. Now they're looking for their second one in two nights, but the Kings have to continue to grind and wear them down. They're down to 5D.
Six players have multi-points tonight for the Kings. Brown, 2 goals. Stoll, goal and assist. Doughty, 2 assists. Gagne, 2 assists. For the Ducks, Bonino with 2 goals. Emerson Edom with 2 assists. Puck is picked up and cleared up the middle, and the Ducks hold it in. Here is a shot knocked down in front. The shot by Cogliano, and the Kings bring it back out to center ice. Kopitar checked there, and the puck, Nolan checked there, and the puck driven down into the Anaheim zone. 33 seconds left to go in the period. Pass to the King line, broken up by Doughty. Gives it to Brown. Now down in deep and chased into the Anaheim zone, taken by Francois Beaujolais. Over to Sheldon Souray. Souray's got a goal tonight. To Cogliano. Cogliano gets stopped. Here's Carter. Carter almost lost it. Then he got it to Richards. Richards checked right at center ice. And the Kings hold it in. Richards with it. Richards down the right side. Tried to poke it in deep. Souray broke it up. Couldn't clear it. Doughty gets it over on the left side. And a shot from there is why Richards tried to tip it in. And that's the end of the second period. Shots for two periods. 26 for the Kings. 17 for the Ducks. But the Ducks lead it 5-4.
It's all about mistakes tonight. We don't normally see that when the LA Kings are involved. Usually it's a solid brand of hockey. Now, give the Kings credit. They fought back and back, trying to get back in this game. That last shift had Carter, Richards, and Gagne. Haven't seen Dustin Penner in a while, so we'll see if that continues to be a change that'll stick the rest of the game. Ducks lead it 5-4 after 40 minutes of play.
When we come back, we're going to join Jarrett Stoll, who's playing in his 600th career game tonight, and enjoy his day with the Stanley Cup.
Welcome back, Honda Center Freeway Face-Off Kings. First matchup of the season against the Ducks, and we've had a high-scoring matchup. It's been a crazy, wild game. Joined right now by Kings assistant coach Davis Payne. Davis, the power play came around tonight, two already. What do you like from the power play tonight?
Well, every time we've executed with good speed and tempo, we've had opportunities to attack and ice to attack from. And Brownie's doing a heck of a job in net front, getting a good screen in that area and getting some second pucks.
I mentioned it's been a crazy game. Anything else you want to see carried over here to the third period in a game that's been kind of weird?
Well, we want to make sure they're D-turned for 20 minutes. We want to make sure we get the pucks into the right areas, have good support going there, but also be on the right side of things. And we feel that if we execute system, we'll get our chance.
All right, Davis, thanks very much. So Davis Payne, get them, but chip it in, allow some support to go on top of it. And keep in mind, the Ducks are down to five defensemen. So keep turning them, keep pounding them, keep hitting them back to back. Sooner or later, you hope to create another one of those turnovers. We've seen a lot of those tonight.
Defenseman Cam Fowler of the Ducks went out. He was really woozy, almost had to be, did have to be helped off the ice, has not returned. So see if that wears down after they played last night and here again tonight. Third period underway. Nine goals scored so far tonight in the game. Five for Anaheim. Puck down into the Anaheim zone. Chased in there by Williams. Williams gets dumped down to the seat of his pants, and the Kings can't hold it in. It came just across the blue line. Scuderi tried to hold it in and just couldn't do it.
I know we've talked about Drew Doughty, Bob. We talked about him earlier, 29 minutes. Rob Scuderi, it's been well documented. He's playing about 4.5 to 5 minutes more than he normally does, but those are different types of minutes. It's almost a complete contrast to Drew Doughty. Doughty's all over the place. Scuderi under control at all times.
Face-off outside the King blue line. Third period just underway. Bob Miller along with Jim Fox.
I mentioned at the end of the second there, Bob, there was a shift with Gagne up. Now Penner is back on the left wing along with Richards and Carter.
And the Kings drive it into the Anaheim zone. It bounces up in the air. Richards tried to hold it in. He couldn't do it. Now it's loose at center ice and swept into the King zone. And Bernier lets it go around the boards, and Kings bring it up to center ice. Pass on the left side to Penner. Penner drives wide, centered in front, and Hiller with a stop, and he hangs on.
So trying to get that center lane drive. The Ducks handle it pretty well and made sure Penner didn't get a chance to get a shot, but still just dump it in there and hope something happens. We'll see if the Kings can sustain some offensive pressure. Not really. The goals haven't been scored off of sustained pressure. It's more like, yeah, like we documented in the second intermission where you make a mistake, it's in the back of your net. There's no really time spent, which is there.
Penner signed as a free agent with Anaheim. He wasn't drafted, signed with them in 2004. He won the Stanley Cup. He was with them when they won the Cup in 2007, but then he signed an offer sheet from Edmonton, 5 years for $21.25 million, and went to the Oilers. Here is Getzlaf down the right side, and a save made by Bernier. Puck held in by the Ducks in deep, and a shot up high and wide to the right. Held in again at the blue line. Beaujolais throws it in and out of the reach of Corey Perry. Getzlaf didn't get it. Kings get it up ahead to Lewis. Lewis checked in front of the King bench, and an icing call coming up against the Kings here. And the faceoff back in the King zone.
Well, new to the season, the LA Kings Player of the Month presented by McDonald's gives you, the fans, a voice to decide who will win the monthly award to an outstanding player. Visit the Kings on Facebook or lakings.com/playeroftheMonth for more details and begin to cast your votes. Your vote counts in more ways than one. You also get a chance to win great prizes from McDonald's.
Bobby Ryan out at center now. They tried him there last night. It worked, and they won the game over Minnesota. He stays out at center. He's got Solani on his right wing, and the puck comes back behind the Anaheim net. Pass up the right side. Here's Teemu Selanne, 42 years old, the Finnish Flash. He throws it down in deep. Martinez back to get it for the Kings. Palmieri goes for it. He's the other winger on this line to the blue line, and a shot and a save by Bernier.
Bobby mentioned Bobby Ryan in the middle, and after the game last night, Bobby was talking about still feeling uncomfortable with that switch, and that can be as simple as, you know, you're in your own zone, what shoulder you're looking over, how you're angling guys to the boards, how close the boards are, because as a winger, you always have the boards there. As a centerman, you're kind of in the middle of the ice. Normally, they say it's more difficult to go from wing to center because of defensive responsibilities down low.
Ducks win the draw. Here's Allen. Brian Allen throws it down into Devontae Smith-Pelly. And now the Ducks moving around right wing side. Back into Smith-Pelly behind the net. Jumping in front of him is Voinov. His pass to the blue line. Held in, though, and a shot wide to the left by Allen. Kings get it to Brown. Up to center ice. Chased down by Voinov. Here's Voinov to Kopitar. Kopitar across the line. Kopitar driving into the corner. Puts on the brakes. Hangs on. Gives it to Voinov. His shot. He partially shanked it. And it's cleared back out to center ice. Voinov going back over to the bench now.
I'll give him a full shank on that one.
Okay. Puck taken, and I thought a full shank was like my golf swing. You miss all together.
I've seen that before.
Not very often lately. Puck taken by the Kings. Drewiski, and he gets it up ahead and out to center ice. Nolan trying to get to it. Nolan has it. Here's Nolan across the line to Carter. Carter, and it's intercepted. They tried to get it over to Carter for a one-timer, and it was intercepted there and sent back by the Ducks down into the King zone, sent around the boards, and a battle there as Muzzin comes over to try and get it loose. Taken by Soure. Now right side. Here's Ludman. Shoots wide. Puck comes over to Winnick. Daniel Winnick gets it back over to Cogliano. Cogliano checked in the corner. It's taken away by Drewiski. Drewiski up ahead to Clifford. Kyle Clifford comes to center ice. His pass to Nolan didn't connect. Ducks get it back again, and Cogliano sends it back behind the King net. Ducks change on the fly.
So far, the Kings are not able to get the puck in behind defensemen. No chips right yet. No forecheck going, so the Ducks clogging things up in the neutral zone.
Spezza intercepted at center ice. Tipped there by Clifford. Not out, and a hand pass called here. So that stops play.
That neutral zone is always so important, maybe more so when you are protecting the lead like the Ducks. So we'll keep an eye if the Kings can get the possession at the red line so they get a chip and placement. You can always dump it in, but what you're looking for is to place it in the spot where support will be there. That's exactly what Davis Payne was talking about when he talked just before this period started. So you got to get the dumps, yeah, but you got to get it in the right spot to get some contact and create separation from that puck.
If you joined us late, Jonathan Quick was the starter. He played 5 minutes and 49 seconds, gave up 2 goals on 3 shots, and Jonathan Bernier came in to replace him, and Bernier has been in goal the rest of the way. Kings get it to the blue line. Now down the left side, Gagne chasing it in. Gagne behind the net. Puck is poked around the left wing side by Brian Allen, and the Ducks get it to center to Getzlaf.
You have a different line combination, Gagne, Penner, and Richards out there.
And Richards tips it away, but he couldn't catch up to the loose puck. Here's Corey Perry now, and Perry sends it deep into the King zone, and the Ducks are going to change. Gagne's going to go off the ice for the Kings. Here to center ice is Kopitar. Kopitar's pass off on the right wing side. A shot save, rebound in front. Brown for the hat trick, and he got stopped by Hiller.
There's Hiller with that calm demeanor, Bob. You mentioned it earlier. Sometimes the rebounds are right there, but Hiller, good position. Pad save on Brown.
Pass went off the back of Williams, and the Ducks with it back in their own zone. Dustin Brown looking for his third of the night, but Hiller made the save, and here is Martinez, and it is tipped up over the glass into the crowd.
Now, the first shot was a concern for the Ducks because there was a rebound. Pretty good movement in the neutral zone that time by the Kings on the counterattack. You see outside Kopitar to Williams. That high shot, the issue is the rebound. But then the reaction of the goaltender, watch how calm and cool Hiller is right here. He senses, just smother. Just get the pad big as possible. But the first one, anytime it's up high into a goaltender's gloves, normally they hold on.
Luca Spezza with it now for the Anaheim Ducks, moved up to center ice. Ducks with a 5-4 lead. We're in the third period. Trevor Lewis back for the Kings. Kings don't return to Staples Center till the 15th of February against the Columbus Blue Jackets. And the Blue Jackets will be the Kings' next opponent Tuesday night. Pre-game show on Fox Sports West, 3:30 in Southern California, Tuesday afternoon. Kings send it over left side to Nolan. Jordan Nolan down in deep. Nolan put it back on the right side. Gets a return pass, didn't get it. Comes back out to the left point. Kings hold it in again. Now Nolan on the left side, and it goes into the corner. Played there around the boards by Spezza. Kings hold it in. Nolan trying to get it behind the net. He bumps into Spezza. Puck is picked up there, and Bonino clears it out to center ice for Anaheim. Here's Doughty backpedaling into the Kings zone. Gives it over to Scuderi. Kings have come from behind 3 times to tie this game, but they need to do it again. They're down 5-4 here in the third. Richards pass Over to Carter. Carter tips it in. Carter goes back behind the net, leaves it for Penner. Penner got tripped up for a moment. Puck comes around the right side, held in by Voinov to Penner. Back up the middle to Richards. His shot blocked. Picked up by Anaheim. Here's Cogliano with a shot deflected wide. Kings go for it back in their own zone and pass up ahead to center ice. Carter knocked it down there, but the Ducks take it away. Now Anaheim, still back in their own zone. Pass up to Getzlaf. Almost intercepted there, but it comes into the Kings zone, and icing called against Anaheim.
Well, the Kings had possession time in the zone, but the block shot gets the Ducks out of trouble. Then it's a good read by a forward and a defenseman. You'll see the block shot coming up right here, then going the other way. Richards, who ended up being the close man, says to Voinov, you come across because you have the angle. It's not always the closest guy. Angles, so important. Good read. Richards allows Voinov to come across. They break up the play.
Getzlaf got kicked out. Kopitar on the draw for the Kings, and he wins the draw. Here's Williams. Justin Williams to the blue line. Shot from there, and Brown tried to tip it in. Couldn't do it. A shot by Scuderi. Puck taken and cleared by Getzlaf out to center ice, but Kings must have touched it. Yeah, we get an offside.
Penalty, Bob, coming up. I think it's against Kopitar. Holding is the call, so the Ducks goal lead. They're going on the power play. Sometimes position is everything. Look at Winnick right here. He has the inside position. Kopitar will reach with a free hand right there. That's the first part of the hold. He keeps it going as he gets near the stick. So anytime you have that free hand become involved on the play, there's a chance you're going to go off. Good call right there against Kopitar. It ends up being an offensive zone penalty, so it's a big one. The Kings need to kill right here. The Ducks did score the first two goals of the game, but since then, it's been kind of one-goal increments the rest of the way. Daryl Sutter looks on. Offensive zone penalty. Big kill here for the Kings. They need this one to kind of stay around here in the third period.
Well, Anaheim is 2-for-2 on the power play tonight. Faceoff is in the Kings zone. Getzlaf, Perry, Bileski up front. Here's Beaujolais at the left point. Soure's back at the right point. Anaheim with a power play. Perry put it down into Getzlaf. Getzlaf checked by Drewski. Got it over on the right side. It's cleared to the blue line, but not out. Beaujolais jumped up in the air and held it in. Behind the net, Getzlaf. Getzlaf feeds it back over to Corey Perry. Perry on the left wing. In the circle, Perry's pass down in deep. Now back in front, tipped up in the air off the stick there of Corey Perry. Perry checked, and the Kings can't clear again. Held in now, Drewski. He does clear it this time out to center and back into the Anaheim zone.
Kings making sure the Ducks are on the outside right there. The big bodies for the Ducks tried to get to the front. The bodies were there, but the puck never got there too.
Francois Beaujolais up to center ice. Gives it to Sheldon Soure. Soure's got a goal tonight. He throws it in deep. Kings get to it. Slap it around the boards and out to center ice. Soure back to get it. Up ahead now to Solani, who's on the ice. He feeds it on the left side. Kings come back, take it away again. And cleared into the Anaheim zone. Cleared that time by Doughty.
Perfect angle by Kyle Clifford. Kyle trying to get as much ice time as possible. He's seeing some time this year on the penalty kill. Took the angle and helped the defenseman break it up.
Across the line, Ducks keep it in. Here's Bobby Ryan, right side. Ryan spent some time in El Segundo, although he's born in Cherry Hills, New Jersey. Back it comes over right side to Koivu. Back up the middle. Spezza feeds it left side. Played off the boards there and down in the corner. Back over and tipped away and out to center ice. Tipped by Scuderi.
There's Rob Scuderi, Bob. He doesn't even move, but he makes the play.
Here is Solani on the right wing. Solani gets checked there. Drops it back. A pass in front. The shot. Not score. Have a 6-4 lead. Nick Bonino with 3 goals tonight.
And really not much happening on the power play until this entry. This is really the only time the Ducks were dangerous, but that's been the story of the game. Bobby Ryan makes a subtle back pass here. He'll give and go. Get it back here. He just gets it and kind of sets it up. You see right there? Shot doesn't get through. Second one does. And Bonino gets a chance to celebrate the hat trick. Look at Ryan right there. He knew Bonino was over there. And the first one is rarely the issue. Many times, it's the second one. But like the game is gone tonight, Bob. Like I mentioned, that was the first time I thought the Ducks really had anything dangerous going. But it's now 6 goals on 21 shots for Anaheim. They've been deadly. They finished off plays. That's the third power play goal for the Ducks. Normally, a strength for the King is the penalty kill. The Kings have two of their own. It's back to being uncharacteristic tonight. Mistakes. You could talk about the goaltending from a save percentage because that will not be good by the end of the game.
Well, they're picking up the hats here. Bonino, born in Hartford, Connecticut. He played 2 years for Boston University. And tonight he gets the first 2 goals of the game and now adds his third for his first career hat trick here in the third period. It is 6-4. Anaheim leads by 2, and they are 3-for-3 on the power play.
A wry smile right there from Bonino, and he deserves it tonight. He's been making it happen. He's getting his feet going. I mean, he's not the biggest of guys, just over 190, but when you have that nonstop action, your feet are moving at all times, that makes it difficult on the checkers. He's also shown tonight some pretty good patience with a puck. The first 2 goals specifically, one with a reach on the backhand, the second one reach on the forehand. But, you know, another thing about it, for the most part, I know Getzlaff has a pretty goal on a great pass from Perry, but for the most part, the big guys for the Ducks really haven't controlled the puck tonight. They haven't had a lot of puck time. It's the other guys, so to speak, doing it for the Ducks.
Bonino with assists from Bobby Ryan and Luca Spezza at 8:39. Now the Kings down by 2. Once again, second time in the game they've been down by 2 goals. Last time they scored twice in 34 seconds to tie the game. We're in the third period with 10:54 to go in the period.
You know the Kings will force things. We'll see if the Ducks pull back or keep going forward.
Ducks take it away in deep and a pass intercepted now by Nolan. Nolan back up to center ice for the Kings. He sends it deep behind the Anaheim net. Kings are changing on the fly. Puck is taken away and Koivu clears it up ahead to center ice for Anaheim. Corey Perry chasing it in with Scuderi. They lean on each other. Scuderi trying to get his stick on it. He got it over to Doughty. Doughty trying to get away from Bolesky. Doughty's pass. Where to go? Up high on the glass, then dropped down and picked up by Scuderi. Now the Kings back up to center. Here is Dustin Brown. He's got 2 goals tonight. Brown, left side. Brown tried to give it to Kopitar. Kopitar behind the net. Rolled away from him, and the Ducks start back to center. Working on a 3-on-2, but Bolesky peels off and goes to the bench, and now the Ducks are going to make a line change. Puck taken by the Kings. Down by 2 goals here in the third. Pass out of the reach, taken now by Williams. Justin Williams at center ice gets it over to Brown. Brown sends it into the zone. Kings Richards trying to keep it alive, and Bonino breaks it up there. Stick handles with it, brings it out to center ice. Checked and knocked down by Richards. Kings have it. Penner, left wing. His shot is wide, deflected off the glass. Picked up by Spezza. Taken away by the Kings, but a penalty against the Kings again.
Yeah, Dustin Penner's going to go off. May have been a slew foot right there, a kick or something. Ryan goes down. Penner goes to the box.
Dustin Penner in the box. 2 minutes for tripping, and the Ducks once again on the power play. I'm Patrick O'Neill. Time for the Carl's Jr. Sports Update. Some injury news. Ray Whitney of the Dallas Stars out 4 to 6 weeks with a broken foot. Former King Wayne Simmonds confirmed by the Flyers. He has a concussion. Didn't play today. No timetable on his return. Columbus, the Kings' next opponent on Tuesday, beat Detroit. Scary moment. James Wisniewski crashed into the end boards. He was down and out for a couple of minutes. Jack Johnson said a huge sigh of relief when he was up, moving, and talking. But a chance to see Artem Anisimov, the new star for the Jackets, acquired in the Rick Nash trade. Bob and Jim?
Anisimov, Patrick, he's a dangler. Big, rangy kid, but great hands, great moves.
Kings came into the game 5th in penalty killing in the league, but it has failed them tonight. The Ducks are 3 out of 3. Soray's shot deflects right back up the middle. He gets it back again. Sheldon Soray, his shot. Ow. That hits Scuderi, and the Kings don't clear. Held in by Soray again. Now down in deep. Scuderi is back up on his feet. He throws a check at Corey Perry. Puck comes around to Richards. He couldn't clear it out. Up the middle, Sheldon Soray. He shoots, and a save by Bernier.
Bernier able to see that one. Scuderi just limping off right now. So just want to take a look at the penalty again, Bob, because there's no question in my mind Dustin Penner deserved a trip. But for the second time in two nights, Bobby Ryan deserves a little embellishment too. He got away with one last night, and he gets away with one there. Now, there was a trip. There was contact in behind, where you can see the flailing of the arms and just throwing his body. So something that he has to keep an eye on, because if the referees get a book on you, tough to get away from it.
Here is Getzlaf, sends it across the ice. Bocheman with a drive off the boards and wide. Back out to the right point. Puck is tipped out to center ice. Kings go for it there, but can't get to it. Stoll up front on the penalty kill. Drewiski is back. And the puck taken by the Ducks. Getzlaf. Getzlaf across the line. He throws it back to the left side. Doughty is out on the penalty kill. Puck comes up the middle right to the Kings, and they get it back up to center ice. Taken by the Kings, Trevor Lewis. Lewis down in deep. Lewis in the corner, eludes a check from Perry. Puck comes toward Kopitar. Now Lewis goes for it. Lewis checked again, trying to get it free. Kopitar in to help out, but the Ducks have the puck. Kopitar trying to take it away. 39 seconds left to go in the King penalty. Kings are down 6-4 here in the third period. Ducks with a power play. Pass down in deep, Bobby Ryan. Ryan to Solani. Solani checked behind the net by Scuderi. Puck comes over to Koivu. Saku Koivu. He put it back in the corner, got it back again. Koivu back to the blue line. Now here's Tony Ludman. Ludman shot gloved by Bernier. And he hangs on.
So the Ducks just keeping it alive, keeping it moving, keeping it in safe spots. There was one chance there where the Kings had a chance for a counterattack shorthanded, but the Ducks get back. So it's a different type of style. You're looking for that goal, obviously, but you're also looking to make sure. You have to know the Kings, especially with the guys they have out there in certain situations. They're going to look for some offense, even while shorthanded.
Faceoff one, and back to the blue line to Spezza. Here's Bonino. He's got three tonight. His pass down in deep to Ryan. Ryan's pass, ooh, that hit to Whiskey. And he goes down to the ice.
You can hear it up here. I'm hoping he got some of the helmet. It looks like he got him right square in the face. So that sound I heard, Bob, was not his helmet.
Wow.
You can tell right away that he's in trouble. Right there, square to the face. He's now trying to block the passing lane. He's there, and he's doing his job, and there it is. Wow, right up the beak. Of course, you can see the blood, and hope his teeth are okay. There's a whole bunch of things, obviously, that can go on there, but you see the crew is out here because immediately the blood was on the ice, so they're just trying to scrape up some of that blood and make it a clean working environment.
Well, they blocked shots. The Ducks have blocked 16 shots. The Kings, 6. That was not a blocked shot. It was a pass that unfortunately hit Drewiski. Jonathan Bernier, his first appearance of the season for the Kings. Off the draw here, the Ducks get it back to Lucas Spezza, right point. They're still on the power play for 3 more seconds. Spezza winds up, doesn't shoot. Here's Bonino, pass down in deep, and a backhander off the crossbar by Solani. And the loose puck is going to be taken by Ryan, but we get a puck knocked out of the air with a high stick.
You know, the Ducks took advantage. Jeff Carter snapped his stick right off the faceoff, so you're already shorthanded, you don't have a stick. One move and there he goes. You're right, Bob. Right off the crossbar. You see Bernier just moving across. Saying, if you're going to beat me, it's going to be a perfect shot. It's just an example there, though, of Solani. Even though he's not in a skating motion, he always is moving. He's changing angles. He's deceptive. He's changing speeds. Not only the top speed, deception works, too.
Solani doesn't have a goal tonight. Here is Kopitar into the zone, right side. His backhander is wide. Solani needs one power play goal for 250 to break a tie with Phil Esposito for third all time. And a shot from the right side to save off the stick of Bernier. And the Kings come back. Here's Brown at center. Tipped away from him, and the Ducks send it back in the Kings zone. 6:45 to go in the third. Kings need two goals to tie. Here in the third period, the Ducks got a goal by Nick Bonino, his third of the game. Kings bring it back. Here's Kyle Clifford. Left side. Clifford tried to throw it in front. He did. And the rebound was tipped right up the middle and taken by Corey Perry. Perry for Anaheim. Perry into Cagliano, to Palmieri. Now cleared out to center. And down in deep. You got Cagliano, Palmieri. Yet Spezza's the only guy from Italy. Puck comes up to center ice. Figure that one out. Here is Richards. He shoots. It's wide. Rebound over to Clifford. Clifford knocked down to the corner, and the puck comes out to the right point. Kings get it left side. Scuderi waits, feeds it back right side. Here's Doughty pulling it back top of the slot. Doughty turns, gives it to Scuderi. Scuderi down in deep in the corner, tried to throw it in front. Richards, shot, rebound, and getting there was Nolan, but couldn't get his stick on it to put it in. Looked like the right corner of the net was open for a moment.
Bouncing around, everyone driving, trying to get his nut bodies to the front. Of course, the Ducks are going to counteract that with as many bodies themselves, collapsing down low right in front.
Puck comes around the left wing into the Anaheim zone. Gagne going for it there. Now Lewis trying to pick it up. Back to Gagne, tipped away. Lewis had been knocked down to one knee. He gets back up, but the Ducks have it and cleared out to center ice. Kings drive it right back in. Kings are desperate for goals to tie this up now. Kings with four goals tonight. Ludman's stick gets knocked up in the air, and he gets it back again. Voinoff gives it over to Martinez. Martinez drives it down the right side into the Anaheim zone. And a pass to the blue line comes all the way back into the King zone and chased down by Alec Martinez. Under 5 minutes to go now here in the third period.
The Ducks certainly not backing off. They're swarming around the puck. They're supporting the puck, especially in their own zone. So if one man can't clear it, the second guy's there.
Kings across the line, right side, in deep, pass in front. Penner was there, couldn't get the pass, and the puck cleared to center and back. The Kings pick it up. Here is Muzzin. Jake Muzzin fires it wide of the net. Taken there by Brian Allen to the blue line. Kings hold it in.
That's Drewiski. He's back out there.
Yeah.
Not even missing a shift. Maybe missed a half the shift.
Made a nice play there, too. Got hit in the mouth with a puck, and he's back in, and he made a nice play to hold it in. Now he drives it back into the Anaheim zone. But now we're down to 4 minutes to go in regulation. The Ducks, who have never trailed in the game, have a 6-4 lead. Trying to win their second in a row and go unbeaten in regulation in four. Puck comes up to center ice. Kopitar across the line. He dropped it to Williams, to Kopitar, to the blue line to Doughty. Quickly over to Scuderi. Scuderi waits. He shoots wide. Rebound taken by Kopitar. Back to the blue line, Scuderi. He holds it in, sends it toward the back of the net. King still with it, getting some pressure on. Here's Scuderi. Scuderi sends it right side. Doughty shoots, blocked in front by Allen. Doughty again. Doughty gets it back, shoots up high and off the glass. Rebound sent wide by Williams. Chased down by Clifford. Clifford to Williams. Williams right side. Williams with Kopitar in front. Williams now to Scuderi. It's shot, saved by Hiller, and he gets the whistle.
First sustained shift in this period by the Kings, and they had opportunities, they had shots. Again, the Ducks collapsing to help out. Ducks still lead it by two. He had my respect before, Bob, but now he has bigger respect.
Boy,
you can see
sure.
Davis Drewiski hit cleanly right in the face, right in the nose. It looks like the nose is broken. I mean, it's curved now more than it certainly was before. You can see that, or at least it's swelling up on one side. A cut underneath the nose. Carmack's upcoming schedule. The Kings continue the five-game road trip. Four more on the road. Columbus, Nashville, Detroit, St. Louis. One back at Staples. Then three more back on the road. Then, of course, Colorado comes to Staples Center on the 23rd. So we're used to this. The Grammy road trip for the LA Kings. They're staying on the road for a while.
Yeah. Davis Drewiski out of Hudson, Wisconsin, and broken nose and comes back and plays. And as you said, Jim, didn't miss much time either.
Just pack it in and get back out there.
Here the left point. Here's Richards. His shot didn't get through. Brown with it. Brown for the Kings. Had it taken away and a shot by Carter just wide to the right. Kings have pulled the goaltender Bernier with 2:52 left to go here in the third, trying to get two goals to tie. Here is Richards. His shot deflected. Not out of play. Some of the players thought it was out of play. Puck taken by Richards again. Kings with the extra attacker to the blue line. It goes to Williams, to Richards. Across the ice, taken by Doughty off the boards. Doughty to Brown behind the net. Brown had it tipped away by Beaujolais with a nice play. Kings try to hold it in, and they do so far. Winnick is there for Anaheim. Carter trying to dig it out. It comes free and cleared out to center ice as the Ducks clear it. Koivu getting it out to center. King's net is still empty. Now with an empty net, here is a shot. Score by Solani from the center ice area into the empty net, and that'll just about do it. 7-4, Anaheim.
The Kings had a sustained pressure shift, then a TV timeout. That's when Daryl Sutter decides to pull the goaltender. I think the decision was okay because it was one of the few times the Kings had some pressure on the Ducks. Keep it going. But after the initial control, the Ducks finally get it out. You see Doughty gets a piece. But somehow, Teemu Selanne will find a way to get it done. So the Ducks weather the storm right there, and they get the empty net by Selanne.
Selanne gets his third of the year. Empty net goal, and now the Kings down by 3 and under 2 minutes to go. Kings Live postgame will be coming up after our game. And the Kings clear it back up to center. Bernier is back in goal for the Kings. Getzlaff takes it away for Anaheim. Here is Alec Martinez back in the King zone. And the pass deflected. Back down into the further into the King zone. Martinez gets it around the right side. Bobby Ryan's going to get an assist on it. Taken away and cleared across the King blue line. And now back to center ice where Stoll tried to pick it up. Selanne is third of the year from Bonino. What a night he's had. 3 goals. He gets an assist here. Ryan with the other assist at 17:54. Here's Kopitar trying to give it to Williams. Tipped away, shot wire pass wide of the net. Then a pass in front. Brown for the hat trick. Loose puck. Covered by Hiller as Kopitar was right there in the crease looking for the loose puck.
Yeah, looking for loose pucks, trying to jam it home. On the ice there on the last shift was Francois Beauchemin. Bob, you mentioned his name quite a bit tonight. And he has been exceptional for the Ducks tonight. He's broken up plays when the Ducks have been under pressure. He's been in the way a couple times. He's just done the job time and time again. Now, I know it's been a weird game, and the Ducks forced the Kings into mistakes, but as far as defending, Beauchemin, excellent tonight.
Kings with it again. They get it into Richards behind the net, but 53 seconds left to go in regulation. Kings down by 3, 7-4. Puck cleared out to center ice and off the skate there of Muzzin. He has to chase it in. Bobby Ryan has 2 assists here on goals in this third period. Puck comes over to Jeff Carter. Carter tried to get it up to center ice, deflected back into the Kings zone. Now the Ducks fans on their feet applauding this victory by Anaheim. Kings have won 3 straight, but not tonight over the Ducks. Puck is cleared back to center and Penner back to get it. 13 seconds left to go in regulation. Puck hops down the left side to Davis Drewiski, now to center. 5 seconds to go. Chased down by Palmieri. Palmieri with it. 1 second left, and that is it. A 7-4 victory for Anaheim, even though the Kings outshoot them 34-25.
Uncharacteristic tonight for the Kings. The Ducks continue to pile it up offensively. They're scoring a lot of goals. There's the man of the moment tonight, Bonino. He started off in the first and then, of course, maybe had the dagger in the third with his goal in the third period. But the Ducks forced the Kings into mistakes, coverage issues by the Kings, things that are normally safe and under control. The Kings never had control, never felt comfort tonight, even when they came back to tie it up. And the Ducks keep rolling. They win it 7-4.
11 goals in the game tonight, 7 of them for Anaheim, and the King record goes to 2-3-2, and they remain with 6 points. A big night for Nick Bonino of Anaheim, 3 goals and 1 assist. We'll be back with Kings Live next.